everybody. It's 6 o'clock now, so let's get this thing started. I just want to thank everybody for coming to participate in this. And supervisors Chadwick, you know, Brandon, we're working together and trying to tackle this and this in a way that really can hopefully bring the community together on this early on. We end up with an ordinance that we can all be proud of. My name is John Brower, and I've been involved with the creation of some of the other ordinances. And this is a great opportunity to get the community together and discuss retail. It's really the missing link in our group of commercial cannabis ordinances here in Trinity. The entire industry is demand-driven, and Trinity County being a globally recognized production center really relies on consumers to demand the product. For the county to take advantage of retail sales is, I think, obvious to many of us. This could be an area where Trinity County can really shine if we do this right. So the state of California has spoken loud and clear now. Passage of the MRSA bills 3 years ago, and then ALMA, the Adult Use Initiative, shortly thereafter. Both of those pieces of legislation got combined into what we now call MLCRSA. And MLCRSA is the statutory framework that allows different state agencies to offer licensing for different types of businesses. And so, briefly, the MLCRSA discusses retail, but only in broad terms. And it defines retail simply. Here's the definition. Retailer, for the retail sale and delivery of cannabis or cannabis products to customers. A retailer shall have a premises, which is a physical location from which commercial cannabis activities are conducted. A retailer's premises may be closed to the public. A retailer may conduct sales exclusively by delivery. That's it. The state offers very little guidance on land use regarding retail. The only land use definitions or restrictions I can find anywhere in the statutory laws is that retail has to be at least 600 feet from a K-12 public school, preschool, daycare center, or residential drug treatment facility. Local county ordinances for other cannabis license types also include churches in that definition and push it out to 1,000 feet for those different things. Our other cultivation ordinance also has a setback from school, what they call authorized school bus stops. It seems that to create a county ordinance, no matter what we put in it, it would have to kind of fit under the umbrella of this state legislation first, and then the state regulations by the BCC. The BCC is the state agency that controls retail cannabis licensing and distribution and manufacturing. There are many regulations pertaining to the operations of retailers, but and that is something that I feel like our county ordinance should not touch on. The actual operations of these licenses is something that should be left up to the state, and I think the county ordinances should stick to focusing on matters related to land use. cities and counties in the state of California have very limited authority to create local laws, and that authority is limited to matters pertaining to land use, and especially through zoning ordinances. So our county can establish zoning ordinances to mitigate nuisances, and I think that's the focus of what we're trying to do this now. So this is, we're hoping this can be a very participatory process, and we're hoping to hear the concerns of the community and hopefully some good ideas too. But the retail element of this commercial cannabis supply chain is being built right now as we speak. Could be a real benefit to the county if it's done right. So the planning staff is prepared to talk about different zoning definitions and things that we can look at and borrow from some other ordinances, retail ordinances statewide, and possibly borrow from some of our other existing commercial cannabis ordinances. Like I said, the ability for the county to regulate anything